Hello YouTube, I wanted to share with you one of my newest, most favorite stories from the eminent Danish author Hans Christian Andersen. Some of his stories are rather long and some are very short. This one's only about a page and a half and it comes from an original volume which he wrote in 1837, or at least it was included in that volume. And it discusses the basic natures and differences of nature between men and women, which the very wise and well-written and well-educated Mr. Andersen was aware of almost 200 years ago. Andersen is very well known for his understanding of the human condition and people in general, so I would like to share with you the story of the sweethearts. A top and a ball were lying in a drawer among a lot of other toys, and one day the top said to the ball, "Shouldn't we become engaged? After all, we're lying right next to each other in this drawer." But the ball, who was made of fine Morocco leather, thought of herself as a very refined young lady and would not even answer a question such as that. The next day the little boy, whose toys were, they all were, painted the top red and yellow and hammered a brass nail in the middle of it. It looked marvelous when it spun. "Look at me now," said the top to the ball. "What do you say? Wouldn't we make a fine pair? You can jump and I can dance, and how happy we would be together." "That's what you think," replied the ball. "Are you aware that my mother and father wear a pair of Moroccan slippers and that I have a cork inside of me?" "Well, but I'm of mahogany," boasted the top. "The mayor made me himself on a lathe he has in his cellar, and it gave him great pleasure." "How do I know what you were saying is true?" said the ball. "Well, may I never be whipped into a spin again if I'm lying," answered the top. "Well, you speak well for yourself," admitted the ball, "but I have to refuse because I am almost engaged to a swallow. Every time I jump up into the air, he puts his head out of the nest and he asks, 'Will you? Will you?' Even though I haven't said yes, I have thought very much about it, and that's almost the same as being engaged, but I promise that I shall never forget you." "A lot of difference that will make," growled the top, and that was the end of their conversation. The next day the ball was taken out of the drawer, and the top watched as she was thrown so high up into the air that she looked like a bird and finally all but disappeared. Every time she hit the ground, she bounced up again quite high, and the top could not make up his mind whether she jumped up like that because she wanted to get another glimpse of the swallow or just because she had cork inside of her. The ninth time the ball went up into the air, it did not return. The boy searched for it everywhere, but it was gone. "I know what's happened to her," said the top. "She's up in the swallow's nest and is getting married to him now." The more the top thought about the ball, the more in love with her he became. And because he couldn't have her, he wanted her all the more. The strangest part of it was, is that she had preferred another. The top spun and whirled, round and round he went, and all the time he was only thinking of the ball. And in his imagination, she grew even prettier and prettier, and the years passed, and finally she became just another old love. The top was not young anymore, but then one day he was painted all over with gold. Now he was a golden top, and he spun and he leapt into the air, and oh, that was something. But then it sprang too high and was gone, and everyone looked for it everywhere, even in the cellar, but it was not to be found. Where was it? It had jumped into the garbage bin. There all kinds of things were lying: gravel, a cabbage stalk, dirt, dust, and a lot of leaves that had fallen down from the gutter under the roof. "Well, this is a fine place to be," thought the top. "I wonder how long my gilding will last here. What a lot of riffraff." The top glanced at the cabbage stalk and then at a funny round thing that looked like a rotten apple. But it wasn't an apple. It was an old ball that had lain for years in the gutter where the water had oozed through and around it. "Well, thank God, at last someone of one's own kind has come, someone I need not be ashamed to talk to," said the ball and looked at the golden top. "I I was made from Moroccan leather by the hand of a fine young lady, and I have a quirk inside of me, although I admit it's hard to see it now. I was just about to marry a swallow when I fell into the gutter under this roof here, you see, and there I have lain and oozed 4 or 5 years, and that is a long time for a young girl as I. The top didn't say anything. He was thinking of his old sweetheart, and the more he heard, the more certain he was that this was she. At that moment, a maid came to throw something away. "Hurrah! There's that golden top," she said. And the golden top was snatched from the wreckage and brought back to the living room, where he was honored and respected. And there was no one ever, and there no one ever talked about the ball, and the top never mentioned that old love again. Yet, you get over it when your beloved has lain in a gutter and oozed for 5 years. You never recognize her when you meet her in the garbage bin. And that, my friends, is from the English translation of the eminent Hans Christian Andersen. Hope you enjoyed it. I did.